You picked up on it. Thank you.
Haven, of course, is one of our great partners with Business Central Florida as well. We've got them here on site with us in our Welcome Center for the entire Fly-In and Expo. Interestingly enough, they just got back from Melbourne, Australia, where they won the Golden Bean World Series, and they are now the best coffee roaster in the entire world. So it's a big thing for us to be able to partner with them and showcase what they have to offer here on the grounds.
Justin, your voice is familiar because folks hear it on the radio all the time. Tell us about the what goes into that radio show and why it means so much to Visit Central Florida.
Yeah, I mean, that radio show is a premier platform for us to be able to promote and showcase all the best events that our team with Visit Central Florida Sports brings in and day out here for Polk County. I mean, we have 300-plus events with, who knows, hundreds of millions of dollars in economic impact annually, and that's just one of many platforms that we utilize in order to showcase those events. You know, and I hear that we've been dubbed the B-team on that show.
On the radio show?
I take that personally.
Sure. It was meant personal.
You know, we're there every week talking about sports, so you guys only do this every other week.
He falls on the B-team. He misses the ugly stepsister.
Oh, yeah.
Or
yes.
I missed it.
That's them. Well, Justin, part of making money for Polk County, that's what Visit Central Florida does.
Sure.
Make money for the county and create jobs. Thousands and thousands of jobs. It's a, you know, a $5 billion a year industry in Polk County alone.
Right.
But part of that success is, has been changing, or has required you to change the strategy about bringing people in here, putting heads in beds, and making cash registers ring. What does that look like, and why do you do that?
Yeah, so, you know, when we first started out, the Welcome Center is now 17 years old, as of just a couple weeks ago. When we first started out, I mean, I think the strategy was to drive as many bodies through the front door there as we could. But we quickly realized over the last few years that we are a 2,000-square-mile county, and the demographics and the psychographics of our visitor are changing rapidly. So we had to change our strategy from a visitor services standpoint to be able to meet those needs of our visitors in that, and meet them at the correct point in the decision-making process while they're in market to hopefully get them to stay longer and spend more money. So over the last few years, to your point, Mark, we've really focused on changing the narrative and focusing more on expanding our efforts across our 2,000-square-mile county, opening up satellite locations at Legoland Florida Resort, our largest attraction, the RP Funding Center, our largest convention center, and now soon to come online here at Lakeland Linder International Airport with welcoming commercial air service and available airlines. We want to be there to ensure that we're meeting those visitors as they're coming into the county. So as you said, Mark, we can make cash registers ring.
Well, it's going to require you, your team, Chris Caprios, who runs Visit Central Florida, the tourism arm, to get into other markets to encourage travelers to make Lakeland, make Polk County their primary destination. Of course, you can unpack once and see it all from here, stealing a line from Jackie Johnson. But the fact is, that's the truth. So, you know, it just doesn't involve what you're doing here and turning our visitors into multi-day visitors, but it's also now going outside the county, as we have done for years with success, especially in Detroit.
Yeah, I mean, you're famous for saying that, you know, sports and tourism is a hyper-competitive market, and we've got to make sure that we have boots on the ground in these new markets that commercial air service is going to open up for us. To my earlier point, making sure that we're meeting those visitors at the critical point in the decision-making process so they not only choose Florida out of the other 49 states, but they choose Polk County out of the other 66 counties that Florida has to offer. And we have so many advantages here in Polk County. Like you said, they can literally stay with us, put their heads in our beds, have the opportunity to go play at the mouse's house, dip their toes in the water at the beaches, but come stay with us and have the opportunity to do it all.
At an affordable price. The affordability and central location, it's hard to fight that. I mean, it's one of our strategic advantages, Jack.
Yeah. So you're a local. You grew up here. This is home. Tell me, as the head of the Welcome Center, where would be three places that you would recommend somebody walking in through the door?
Wow. Put me on the spot.
Yeah, I mean, there's thousands of them.
I know.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
just three.
That's the beauty of Polk County, though, that there is. There's such a diverse array of different things to see and do in Polk County. But off the top of my head, I think something that really sets us apart are our outdoor activities, obviously, with the chain of lakes in Winter Haven, 20-plus lakes connected by canals, We've got a great pontoon boat cruise, Living Water there. I personally love Circle B Bar Reserve. You have the opportunity to go see an immense amount of wildlife, walk the nature trails, and it's free, which is for everybody, especially most of the demographics that are coming out of Florida. If it's free, it's for me, right? You know, you can't forget Legoland Florida Resort or Bach Tower. I personally love our downtown farmer markets. Being able to go downtown on Saturday, hit the Lakeland Club or Lakeland Downtown Farmers Market, grab a cup of coffee, not Starbucks, but a cup of coffee. It's a great time.
We lost another sponsor just like that,
right? Grab Haven Coffee if you're downtown or whatever.
That's right.
But I mean, to my earlier point, Polk County has such a diverse array of different things to see and do. You know, in the Welcome Center, we get people day in and day out that are just sick and tired of the concrete jungles, or as Mark likes to say, the two mountains of conceit, or the valley of humility between the two mountains of conceit.
And in an area that has expanded as well. So, I mean, Davenport and Haines City have expanded, and there are offerings for folks right there as well.
Oh, of course. You know, Davenport, where we're at the Welcome Center, we're 7 miles west of the Mouse's House at Disney World. I mean, that northeast corridor is the most rapidly growing portion of Polk County, which is the most rapidly growing county in the entire country. So there is no shortage of opportunity to come try a local cuisine, try something different that you're not going to get in Orlando or Tampa. So come here, put your head in our bed, stay a while, spend your money here, make those cash registers ring. You can easily do it.
Well, let me jump into that real quick. You know, spend your money here. Now, you have a program that is, quite frankly, nationally known. It's called the Cash Program.
Yeah.
And it's designed to do just that, creating brand ambassadors, friends and family, a big part of the mix that come here to Polk County, okay? But tell us about the CATCH program and what that does, not only, you know, for visitors in general, but also for the sports teams, because there's another program that you have there that's just absolutely phenomenal to make that experience world class.
So we know through our research with our third-party market research company down in St. Germain, 52% of our visitors that come to Polk County, one of their primary reasons is to visit friends and family. So it's incumbent upon us as the DMO to ensure that we're getting to those friends and family and making local brand ambassadors out of them to prevent leakages so they're staying in Polk County, spending more money and staying longer, and then coming back and doing it again. When they're coming to see their friends and family, where we want them to take them to our local restaurants or our local coffee shops or visit our attractions versus going outside the county. So the CATS program that you touched on is our Certified Ambassador of Tourism Sports, born out of the old hip tour program or the hospitality industry professional program.
Too many people with bad hips in our office.
Right.
We had to change that.
We use that program to really reach out to anybody that's passionate about Polk County, that loves to talk about it, that wants to see and do more in Polk County, and really wants to keep those individuals in our county. So it furthers our economic climate and the quality of life. So anybody that's willing to take their opportunity to sit down for a couple hours, learn about everything there is to see in Newport County, free of cost, we'll certify you as an ambassador so that way you can tell everybody what there is to see and do while they're here.
That's amazing. I mean, you know, it could be a PhD dissertation to describe everything that you're doing right now with tangible results. And one of those tangible results that is verified through research. The fact that every person that you talk to, not you necessarily,
right,
but your staff, the CATS and everybody else, increases their spend in the county by $78. That's just phenomenal per person.
You know, if we could push the 5.8 million visitors to Polk County through the doors of our Welcome Center, we would, but we can't. So that's why the paradigm has shifted for us, and we've changed the way we operate. We've started to onboard local brand ambassadors that act as the extension of my team to ensure that they're singing the same song when they're talking to our visitors, preventing those leakages and keeping those individuals here, spending that $78 per person when we're here in the county.
Well, one last question. We've got like 20 seconds left.
Yeah.
So if you were to recommend the first thing that they should do when they come here to Sun and Fun, stop by your visitor center.
100%. Stop by our visitor center. Get a free sample of fresh Florida orange juice. Try the award-winning Haven Coffee. We've got the best team, the best product, the best information here on site.
And the best maps.
Oh, absolutely. Make that your first stop, everybody. And it's, what is it officially called, map, and so people can
So it's the local information center on the map.
Okay, there you go, everybody. Justin, thanks so much for joining us. Wow, what a job you're doing, and making sure those cash registers are ringing, and there's heads in beds, and this week, there's not a problem with that.
If you enjoyed this interview and want to watch more Sports Central, click the video below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.